Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. Chilling CCTV footage has captured the final moments of a British woman who fell to her death from a 10th-floor Benidorm balcony during a friend's hen party. Kirsty Maxwell is filmed staggering along a corridor in the Payma Apartments in the Spanish resort just hours before she died. The newly released video, captured on a hotel CCTV camera, shows the friends, each wearing their hen-do outfits as they make their way to a lift in the building. More footage shot on a mobile phone shows Mrs. Maxwell, from West Lothian in Scotland, asleep in bed on April 29 last year. CCTV footage from a camera in the hotel shows Kirsty Maxwell, far right, arriving back to the hotel with friends at 5:35 a.m. The timestamp on the video is incorrect by 1 hour. The video then shows the group waiting for a lift. Ms. Maxwell is on the left with her back to the camera. The group had returned to the apartments at 5:35 a.m. The timestamp on CCTV was 1 hour out. A short time later she went to sleep, and a friend decided to film her on her mobile phone because she started snoring. This video was shot at 6:50 a.m. Just over an hour later, at 7:51 a.m., Mrs. Maxwell fell to her death from the balcony of apartment 10E, on the 10th floor, which was occupied by five men from Nottingham. The men, dubbed the Benidorm Five, were all quizzed by police but were allowed to return to the UK. Mrs. Maxwell is filmed by a friend on her mobile phone asleep in her hotel room at 6:50 a.m. An hour later she fell to her death. Kirsty Maxwell, 27, pictured with her husband of 6 months Adam, from West Lothian in Scotland, was on a friend's hen party in the Spanish resort of Benidorm on April 29 last year when she died. Kirsty Maxwell, a timeline of her final hours. Kirsty Maxwell arrives in Benidorm with 19 friends for the hen do. The group check into Payma Apartments at 9:15 p.m. on Friday, April 28. They head out into Benidorm to celebrate. At 5:35 a.m. on Saturday, April 29, Mrs. Maxwell returned to her apartment with two friends. At 6:50 a.m. she fell asleep in her hotel room and was filmed snoring. At 7:51 a.m. she fell to her death from a balcony in another hotel room on the 10th floor, occupied by five men. In the following days the men, dubbed the Benidorm Five, were all quizzed by police but were allowed to return to the UK. They deny any wrongdoing and police are still investigating the bank worker's death. The CCTV footage has featured in a new BBC documentary Killed Abroad, which aired in Scotland this week. It also features an interview with Mrs. Maxwell's family, of West Lothian, Scotland, who appealed for new information. Her widower Adam, 28, who married Mrs. Maxwell just 7 months earlier, said, "We made a promise as a family that we would leave no stone unturned for Kirsty. This was my Kirsty. The circumstances surrounding it were impossible to believe. They still are. It was just me and the rest of the family doing the investigation as such, which was hugely difficult. At the same time we were organizing Kirsty's funeral, I was organizing second autopsies to be done. Tests have confirmed that Mrs. Maxwell was more than 3 times the drink drive limit when she died, but had not taken any drugs. Mrs. Maxwell had been drinking with friends before she left them for a different hotel room occupied by five men she did not know before falling from this balcony." A picture shows where Mrs. Maxwell fell to her death in April last year. Three of the men are pictured covering their faces as they came out of a court hearing. Her family have also blasted any suggestion that she jumped. Her brother Ryan Curry told the documentary, "She was at the happiest point in her life, and so was everyone else. Really content with life at that time, and it just changed overnight." Joseph Graham, Callum Northridge, Ricky Gannon, Anthony Holhouse and Daniel Bailey were part of a group of 50 men on holiday together at the time of Mrs. Maxwell's death. In a previous statement, four of the men branded the incident a tragic accident, and argued their names had been dragged through the mud. Spanish authorities have insisted the investigation into Kirsty's death remains open. They believe Kirsty may have mistaken the apartment for a friend's flat and become disorientated. Another of the five men is pictured covering his face as he left court left, along with Ricky Gannon, right.